Rob. Well, let's go from Ram. Let's skip Rob. Let's go from Ram to Envy Ram. What's Envy Ram? Envy Ram is the hard drive of the router. That's where you're going to save all your information to. Okay? So the startup config, which is the name of the file, that's where it gets saved to. It gets saved to NVRAM. So when you do the copy run, you're saying copy running config, copy run startup config. So copy run start really means copy what's in RAM to NVRAM. Okay? That's what you're doing. Alright, so startup config is the main thing that I want you to pay attention to here. Okay? Yes.
I just made it up.
The command. Copy, run, start. Okay? What are you doing when you do that? Run is the running config, and start is the startup config. You're telling the router, copy what's in RAM. Copy whatever is in RAM to NVRAM. That's all you're doing. Now, it's going to ask you, do you, because in brackets, it's going to tell you, right? When you hit copy run start, you hit enter, remember? And there's the name of the files right here, startup config. It's in brackets. Mm-hmm. And then it's waiting for you to do something. So all you gotta do is hit enter. Because you are acknowledging, you're saying, yes, I agree. That's the name of the file that I want to copy it to. If you write anything else, you're creating another file, or you may be overwriting this file. Well, not overwriting it, you're gonna be changing the name of the file. Okay? So all you gotta do is hit enter. That's it. And it'll copy it to this file. So when you do this, that's what you're doing. Did that answer your question?
Yeah.
Okay. We good with this? Wrong. What's wrong? It's your bootstrap. Oh my god, put bootstrap. Bootstrap, and you have a mini iOS in there as well. That's how your computer boots up. Okay? That's how it gets kickstarted. It goes to ROM. From ROM, it goes somewhere else, which I'm not telling you right now, and then it goes to NVRAM. Okay? If your router ever boots up in ROM monitor mode, with these 1841s and these 2600 series routers, you'll be somewhere it looks like this.
That's a headache.
ROM. Yes. That means there's, something went wrong. Okay? Something's up or somebody changed the registry, which we'll get into in a little bit. Okay? So you need to be careful with this. Hopefully, now I'll tell you what, my experience, somebody wrote copy run strat, strat, and for some reason it deleted the flash, which the important thing here, it's your operating system. So I don't know how that happened, but it did. Okay, then what happens, your router boots up like this. It's like a little safe mode. There's commands in there that you can type so you can reload a flash file, or the iOS file, back in flash. You didn't get rid of your flash, you got rid of what's inside flash. All right, so you can load back the iOS or the operating system of the router through ROM. Okay, but it's a headache, it's just painstaking that has to happen. Okay, so that's, if you see yourself there, it could be various reasons, which we'll get into. Okay, but that's ROM monitor mode. It's your bootstrap, that's how everything starts, but also holds its little mini operating system in there so you can troubleshoot and get the router back up. Okay?
You just type erase flash. Huh?
No. Don't type that. Please don't type
that. No se puede borrar el flash.
Yes.
Okay. Entiendo que sí puede haber un error en el flash, diferentes causas, pero el sistema siempre va a tener la opción para restablecerlo.
No. No, no. This is
entonces
no recovery.
Uno puede crear un backup del flash.
You have to. You, so there's something called copy, flash, TFTP. You always want to back up your flash. You always would like, it would be nice, to back up your configurations. You back them up. You should. So that way you can bring it back. Because if somebody puts delete flash, erase flash, and you get rid of the flash, now your router won't boot. Now your router will be into Raman, and it'll tell you step by step, all right, to download, okay, set this IP, set that IP, blah, 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 and then it'll go ahead and upload it from a TFTP or an FTP server. There is no recovery. There is no F5, F12, auto system. No. No, there's not. Okay? So make sure you backed up your flash. Unless now there's newer routers that I don't know about, or, you know, newer technology that I don't know about, then they can do that. But as far as I know, with the 2610XM, 2620, 1841, 1901, okay? All those routers, when the flash is gone, you have to go through that process to bring it back from a TFTP or an FTP server that you backed up, hopefully. But the good thing, and that's another thing, if you have a 2600 router and you have an 1800 router, your operating systems are not compatible. You must get it from another 2600. You must get it from another 1800. You must get it from another 1900. They're not compatible between one another. That's why also knowing how much RAM you have. Experience is great. I deleted the flash. And then I said, let me put this new flash on here. Let me put this new iOS. Not enough space. Because this router only had 16 megabits of RAM, where the one that it came with was 32. It had the space, this one didn't. So I deleted it, and I didn't have the flash to put back into it. So be very careful.
So we need to have the backup? The
always have the backup, and always make sure that you have sufficient RAM, okay? That's going to be able to hold that, because you may have sufficient flash to hold the file, but if you don't have enough RAM when it boots up to hold it in memory, it won't load it. It'll store it, but it won't load it. You understand? So very important that you know the amount of memory you have and the size of your flash file. Okay? All right, so that, okay, now the router, the boot up process. First thing, of course, the post, right? ROM. After it goes through the post, checks all the hardware, loads the operating system, correct? After it loads the operating system, it looks for the configuration. All right? Hopefully it won't find any issues and it went wrong. But if it finds a configuration, it will load it. If it does not find a configuration, you will come up in a mode, okay, that's going to be called setup mode, right? No configuration on the router, blank router, comes up in setup mode. What is that question that it asks you? Do you want to enter the auto configuration dialog? Do you want to enter the auto configuration dialog? Yes or no? What do we say?
No.
Why? Because we need to do it from scratch. If not, you go through a wizard. What is the router's name? Banner. This interface. Blah, 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 blah. Right? No. We want to do it from scratch. So we say no. What if it asks you after that? Do you want to terminate auto install? Yes. Because you don't want to auto-install it. You want to terminate it, right? Mm-hmm. Once you do that, there's no configuration on the router, right? The router boots up, it goes through its hardware check, looks at all the interfaces, turns them up, brings them down, right? Tells you all the copyright information, whole bunch of stuff, right? Whole bunch of information, the name of the iOS, how much RAM you have. Now you hit, it says press enter to continue, you hit enter, and now you find yourself here.